This is Katavina. She goes crazy in the mornings. And that's Tecate. Hi, you.
The actual project started back in 1998 when Espacios Naturales recognized that there was a need to conserve the Peninsular Pronghorn in Baja. At that point, the wild population was down to about 250 animals, and so they embarked on a captive breeding program. We came and got involved in 2000 and started discussions about how the LA Zoo could help, given our really strong history of breeding pronghorn, managing pronghorn here at the zoo. Are a very unique species. They're basically a relic from the Ice Age. There used to be several different species of pronghorn. Now there's only one species, and this is the last of this family. And the Peninsular pronghorn are all highly adapted to a desert environment. They're only located in the Vizcaino Desert Preserve in Baja, and a very harsh environment.
All my life I've been a traveling man.
This season we sent seven different teams over a 3 month period to hand rear 12 fawns because they are very flighty animals by nature. And so if they're not hand reared, they could actually hurt themselves a lot in trying to transfer them. We'd get up about 6 o'clock, quick cup of coffee, and you head out to check all the animals.
We separate them four into a stall. We have 12 fawns total. Come on, stretches. Nice stretches. These guys get 5 meals currently.
So what I'm doing is making the formula for the fawns, and what they're getting is 50% evaporated goat's milk to water, and then they get a formula, a powder, that's mixed in too.
And in the mornings we do the calculations and figure out how much they should get every day, every meal. So everything is very calculated.
We are fortunate enough to have Julio, a veterinarian from Mexico City, and he's been awesome.
All right, it's feeding time.
Another meal?
After the first meal, usually they are ready to go outside. The troops are gathered. You can hear when they're running by their stomach sloshing from all the milk.
Yeah, they're extremely fast, fastest mammal in North America. Basically because they're adapted to outrun the American cheetah, who they evolved with during the Ice Age times.
You just got out here, are you already tired? And they spend most of their time out here. We usually bring them in after for their 6 p.m. feeding and then put them away for the night. The problem is, sometimes it gets really windy. Maybe by 3 p.m., if we have to, we'll bring them in, and then we'll come back at 6 to feed them again.
A good outcome would be to get, upward 1,000 animals in various locations throughout Baja that are essentially free-ranging. It would be really nice if we could get some more cooperation with the ranchers down there so that fences can be either removed or adjusted so the animals can migrate naturally to where water is rather than right now. I mean, they're sort of stuck where they're at and can't move north when there's lack of water in the southern part of their habitat. Having the animals here in the States is basically an insurance population should anything happen down in Baja. Our biggest fear would be disease or natural disasters. You know, they do get hurricanes down there that could potentially be devastating to the population. And these fawns, 6 are coming to the LA Zoo sometime late June, early July. There is a potential of doing some reintroductions into Southern California deserts and utilizing Peninsular pronghorns. they started out in 1998 with 5 fawns that they pulled for hand rearing as part of their captive breeding program, and now we've got close to 450 animals. So that gives us a lot of potential to reintroduce animals back into their natural habitat once we can secure that habitat. And so this is what it's all about, in my mind, is conservation of species or preserving the species.